quick recap, this is how the most energetic laser in the world works. Up to 192 laser beams are directed at a target the size of an eraser head inside this target chamber. Inside the target is a capsule about the size of a peppercorn, and this holds fuel, typically a heavy kind of hydrogen, that when shot at by these lasers gets compressed into super high energy and density states. Scientists here at the National Ignition Facility do this to achieve nuclear fusion and to understand some of this really cool extreme physics that goes on in these interactions. And in our last video, we talked about how perfecting the target and the capsule can improve these experiments. And that often involves diamond, but probably not the kind you're picturing. In this video, we're gonna talk about another kind of NIF target optimization, but this one involves spiders.
When you are in these experiments, anything that breaks symmetry and anything that is making some noise in the measurements is going to decrease your yield. So the general path is to try to remove all these things that are disturbing the symmetry of the system.
Now, remember, the capsule sits inside the target, but it can't just be like rolling around in there. It has to be perfectly centered so we can try to generate as much energy as possible from the reaction. In the past few years, the goal has been to minimize the points of contact between the capsule and the target. Hopefully, this will decrease the disturbance to the reaction and increase the energy yield. So, what about suspending the capsule from ultra-thin wires?
The problem with metals is that when you make very thin wires below 10 micrometers, they tend to be very brittle and they break. And the next thing is, okay, let's gonna use something that is the strongest material that is about the same thickness that we need, and we start using spider silk.
Yeah, you heard that right. Spider silk.
It's one of the strongest materials in nature. The only problem with the spider silk is that the properties of the spider silk depends on the environment, especially relative humidity and the room, etc. And also depends on the spider that is making it. So they have this spider farm. When they have the spiders and they were like retrieving the spider silk and collecting it to make these kind of structures where they can support the spheres with, you know, this spider web. And they have a super spider that was making the best spider web, and suddenly the spider died. And they were, oh no, we don't have more really high quality spider silk. So eventually to say, okay, this is not gonna work, because even though spider silk seems to be a very good product, so it has a lot of variables that we cannot control. So let's gonna go to another man-made product.
To avoid any further spider-related finickiness, the LNL team has now moved to creating what's called carbon nanowire.
Everyone knows carbon when you go to barbecue, you have charcoal, so you have this black thing that you have carbon, that's carbon. But also you have diamond that you have seen it, this shiny transparent stone, and it's actually the same element. It's the same carbon atom, but the only difference between both of them is just the way the atoms are arranged. Same element, but they have totally different properties.
One structure of carbon discovered in the past few decades is what's called a carbon nanotube. This is where the carbon atoms have an extremely strong chemical bond that forms them into a tight cylindrical structure that's actually stronger than steel by weight. But as the name suggests, they are still only in the nanoscale. They can't grow to the length the NIF team needs to suspend the capsule in the target. So, of course, the team grew a forest and spun some yarn. I'll let Xavier explain.
Carbon atom yarn is made of a myriad of carbon atoms. And basically, you grow the carbon nanotubes in arrays that look like carpets. One sometimes would refer to these arrays of carbon nanotubes like carbon nanotube forests. And then what we do is that this particular forest, you start pulling from one of the edges and the carbon nanotubes start self-assembling. So you just start pulling one of the carbon nanotubes there because they have physical interaction and friction between them. So you start pulling the next one, and then it pulls the other, the next one, and the next one, and the next one. And it's like a chain reaction, you want to call it like that.
And this chain reaction is essentially weaving individual carbon nanotubes together into one longer fiber, creating the carbon nano yarn that can support the capsule inside the target, reducing imperfections in the reaction when the NIF shot goes off. It's basically artisanal.
So, and it has a lot of challenges on it because you have to do everything by hand under the microscope because still the process is very manual. So even a naked eye, it's difficult to see them when they are there. We currently can make fibers less than 10 microns in diameter, and we're pushing the technique to go all the way to 1 micron as a suitable replacement for the spider silk. So, but it's a very interesting project. It's really fun. It feels really rewarding that you are helping to the scientific advancement, you know, to try to give the tools to the physicists so they can improve the yield and hopefully reach to ignition.
And that's one of the coolest things about NIF science. Progress in one area pushes forward innovation in others, like our understanding of nuclear physics, the diagnostic equipment that measures what happens during a shot, the computing that helps simulate these nuclear interactions or processes all the data produced by an experiment, or maybe just taking inspiration from nature. It's pretty clear though that whatever happens next at NIF, it's gonna be pretty wicked cool. If you have questions about this work or something else happening at the lab, leave it for us in the comments. And don't forget to watch the other part of this video where we dive into how diamonds are used at the NIF. Make sure you subscribe to this channel to catch more videos just like this. And as always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.